الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ما بعد. So this is in response to the president of France and their parliament and their system in which they have now banned the burqa and the niqab that the Muslim women choose to wear. And really, it's very unfortunate that they've chosen this path and that they are even contradicting their very so-called democratic principles that they stand on as a nation, as their constitution states that the French people solemnly proclaim their attachment to the rights of man and the principle of national sovereignty and so forth. They say, by the virtue of these principles and that of the self-determination of peoples, a republic offers to the overseas territories which have expressed the will to adhere to them new institutions founded by the common idea of liberty, equality, and fraternity conceived for the purpose of their democratic development. So this is their policy for overseas places. Is it so-called that they wish for other nations to have self-determination, and other French territories that have self-determination of the peoples, equality, liberty, and fraternity. And this is for the purpose of their democratic development. Well, what about the development of the Muslim women that choose to wear the hijab, that choose to wear the niqab? As the article number one in the French Constitution states, France shall be an indivisible, secular, democratic, and social republic. Okay, that is your choice to choose secularism. It shall ensure the equality of all citizens before the law, without distinction of origin, race, or religion. It shall respect all beliefs. It shall be organized on a decentralized basis. Well, by banning the dress that the Muslim women choose to wear, it seems to me that you violated the distinguish of origin or race or religion, because they chose to wear those garments in accordance with the so-called democratic tradition that you uphold. So where does your so-called secularist democratic values lead you? It leads you to begin to prohibit those people who are expressing themselves, expressing their religious faith, their faith, and they're not, pushing this upon other people. No one is going around France, and I've never been to France, but I'm sure no one is going around forcing people, forcing non-Muslims, or even Muslim women for that matter, to cover up. This is the choice of the believing women, that they choose to follow this path, because this is the path that was legislated for us as Muslims. This is in accordance with the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because when the believing women received the verse from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had the revelation revealed to him about the hijab, the believing women, they practiced it. And the way they practice it is the way the believing women of today attempt to practice it. They covered up their face. They tore their waist garments and they covered up their face. This is what the believing women did. So why would you choose another path besides the believing women? And this is a exhortation to those women who choose not to wear the niqab. So, for example, if you you believe that it's something that is recommended instead of an obligation, but looking even to the Muslim traditions of the past, up until the fall of the Ottoman Turks, a lot of the Muslim nations, the women, they covered themselves and they covered their faces. It is only a recent phenomenon that we see that the women have begun to come out of their garments. So again, I encourage and urge the French Parliament to rethink this, because this is, it appears to some as if it is an assault on Islam and against those very so-called values of liberty and equality and fraternity and which is for the purpose of their of democratic development, it seems to me that this contradicts those very beliefs. And so we ask Allah the Almighty to guide you and have a and help you to change your heart, and that you become Muslim. And if you choose not to become Muslim, that's your choice. But however, we urge you to rethink these laws, rethink these things which contradict your very foundation of what your republic is supposedly built upon, that you should have a more open view to see that no one is trying to insult or assault the values of the French Republic, but rather they're showing that that one of the things that are should be intrinsic to a democratic society is that it respects the diversity of others, and that it doesn't repress other peoples who have different cultures, as long as those cultures aren't harming the other people. And of course they're not, but rather you should begin to look at the benefits of women who are not running around naked and running around showing themselves and causing a greater harm in the society. Would you in fact be pleased with your daughters to be running around naked so anyone can view them and take part in enjoying other kind of activities with them? I really don't think so. I don't think any thinking man and any man with any kind of respect for himself and his family, that he would enjoy that other people look and lust after his daughters and lust after his wife. So even in the Western tradition, you'll find that the women used to dress in a very conservative manner, covering themselves, even if they didn't cover their faces, even according to the Christian views, and just even the general views of moral tradition, you'll find that people covered themselves. The women, the believing women cover themselves, and even the women who were not believers, they covered themselves. They were conservative, and they had a respect for their bodies and did not encourage everyone to just view them and disrespect them and encourage and cause these harms that are caused from the women showing themselves in any kind of way and disrespecting themselves, and for other people viewing them and disrespecting them. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, to make this be of benefit, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides the French people to not have a hostile view towards Islam and the Muslims. And may Allah bless the believers everywhere. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.